One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking of you. Give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow I'm just a woman. Help me believe in what I could be and all that I am. Oh, show me the stairway that I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking of you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yes. When you walked among men, well, Jesus, you know, if you're looking below, that is worse now than then. Oh, there's pushing and shoving, and it's crowding my mind. So, Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking of you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Good morning. We are about to celebrate the life of Albert Radix. Please, everyone, stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Albert died with Christ, rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory.
Jesus, 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 Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We have the victory. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Demons will have to flee.
For when we stand.
For when we stand. In the name of Jesus. Tell us who can stand before us. When we stand. In the name of Jesus, we have the victory.
God is so good.
God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good.
Sing, He's all I need.
He's all I need, my Jesus.
Welcome to the funeral mass for Albert in the St. Matthew Roman Catholic Church, Grand Heights, Brooklyn. We are celebrating the mass of the resurrection, source of our hope, that all who die in Christ also rise with Him. Let us pray. O God, our Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, the servant Albert, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. Arnel, we'll read our first scripture reading.
Good afternoon, everyone. A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought of affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction, but they are in peace. For before men, indeed they be punished, yet as they hope full of immortality. Chastise a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them, but found them worthy of himself. As gold in a furnace, he sold them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself, and those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. And this is the word of the Lord.
For the responsorial psalm, it's okay if you sing with us the refrain. It says, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want." Listen.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Together.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. The Lord.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
He guides me in right paths. For his name's sake, even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil. For you are at my side, with your rod and your staff that gives me courage. Lift your voices.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Only goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. Sing the Lord.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall.
Sing it out. The Lord is my shepherd.
There is nothing I shall.
Nyron will read for us our second scripture reading.
Good afternoon. A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We are indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might be the newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ raised from the dead. There is no more. There no longer has power over him. This is the word of the Lord.
Please stand. There are many rooms in my Father's house.
Alle, alle, alleluia. Alle, alle, alleluia. Alle, alle, alleluia. 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 Alle, alle, alleluia. Alle,
the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the soldiers came to the place called the Skull, they crucified Jesus and the criminals there, one on his right, the other on his left. Now, one of the criminals hanging there reviled Jesus, saying, "Are you not the Christ? Save yourself and us." The other man, however, rebuking him, said in reply, "Have you no fear of God? For you are subject to the same condemnation. And indeed, we have been condemned justly, for the sentence we receive corresponds to our crime. But this man has done nothing criminal." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." He replied to him, "Amen, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated.
My dear friends, today we gather to pray for the repose of the soul of Albert and to plead God to keep him mercifully at his judgment seat. And that is why we are celebrating the central celebration or sacrament of the Catholic Church, the Holy Eucharist, the Holy Mass. At every Holy Mass, we read from Scripture to prepare us for the other form of encounter with Jesus at the table of sacrifice. And at the altar, the priest will proclaim those words upon common elements that we use, wafer or loaves of bread, unleavened bread, and wine, specifically for the man, not just any kind of wine, not just any kind of bread. This bread is unleavened to reflect what the people of God did when that night they were supposed to move or relocate from Egypt to their new home. The information was giving them less than 24 hours. They had to vacate their homes and leave because the Pharaoh at the time had agreed that Moses to take them away. And because they had no time to prepare the flour and add yeast for it to grow before they baked bread, they have to bake bread without yeast. We call it unleavened bread. That is what we use also to celebrate the Mass. The priest proclaims the words, asking the Holy Spirit to descend upon bread and wine, so they become the body and the blood of Christ. And we Catholics believe that when this happens, the bread and wine, their substance is transformed. So we say transubstantiation. It becomes the real body and blood of Christ. That's why when you attend the Catholic Mass, you will notice you make every effort that not even a drop or a piece of the bread or a drop of the wine to spill. And after the Mass, the bread and the wine that has been blessed still remains the real body and blood of Jesus Christ. So whatever is left over, we keep in the tabernacle, the center of the church. And so you go to any Catholic church and you see the red light burning, means that the Catholics have kept the body and the blood of Jesus, the body of Jesus in the tabernacle there. So the Catholics also make every effort to train, to prepare the members, you receive First Communion, you learn about the church, and you are convinced that what you are receiving is going to receive is the body of Jesus. You receive First Communion, you get confirmation, and if you are married in the church, then you can accuse yourself of sin, you go to confession, you receive forgiveness of sin, then you can receive Communion. And to celebrate the Mass at the funeral of any Christian is the highest form of honor the Catholic Church gives this one who is lying before us. So Albert today is receiving the highest form of celebration in the Catholic Church as we celebrate the Mass. And on this day, as I said, before we have the Eucharist, we listen to the Word of God. The first reading we were taken from Wisdom chapter 3, 1 to 6 and 9. Now, for the benefit of those who might be wondering, where did we pick this book from? It is the one of the scripture texts that were compiled by the Greek, the Jews, when they were living in exile. And because they were Greek-speaking Jews, these compiled the Old Testament from Hebrew to Greek. And based on their experience of the Greek of Greek philosophy, they were able to make new writings, which the Catholic Church accepted as the true word of God. But because the Protestant Reformation accepted only the Hebrew version of the Old Testament, that's why most churches that are not Catholic accept only the Hebrew version of the, that's why they don't have books like Wisdom made. Now, Wisdom in this reading is making a reference to a common philosophy which is among them, namely that when we all die, because the tradition at the time or teaching at the time, when we all die, we go to Sheol. And in Sheol, there is no discrimination between good people or evil people. So whatever life we led, good or evil, when we die, we go to Sheol. So those who were perpetrating evil were taunting the good ones. So after all, when we all die, we shall go to Sheol. There's no distinction between us. So the author of Wisdom tried to debunk this idea and say, no. When you die, he says, in the view of the foolish, those who pass on are dead. But Wisdom is saying, no, they are dead, and yet they are blessed by the Lord. They are the ones who enjoy the justice of God. And he asks that because of their hope of immortality, they will live with God. This is the novel thinking in old Israel at the time. Because hardly would the old Testament scripture, refer to a form of immortality. But now, the writer shows us that no, even though we go to Sheol, we shall just see the faith of God, and they will live forever, whereas the evil would not have the same experience. The second reading is from Romans 6. Selected verses. When we are baptized, we are baptized into Christ Jesus. So when we were not Jews, the people to whom God initially called to be his own, but when we also, who are non-Jews, when we are baptized, we have been baptized into the death of Christ Jesus, and so we shall also live with Christ since Christ lives forever. That is why celebrating the life of Albert, we are celebrating the moment to recall that he was baptized into Christ Jesus. So now that he is passing, we believe that he would also rise with Christ. But we know that Christ, St. Paul says, raised from the dead, dies no more, and death no longer has power over him. And so all who are baptized into Christ Jesus, when they die, they are dead no more, but they rise with Christ. In the Gospel reading from Luke 23, 33 and 39 to 43, Luke 23, 33, 39 and 43, is the popular story we know. Stories we hear on Passion, the Passion Week, that Jesus was crucified and on his left as a criminal, on his right as a criminal, and one was taunting him, and the other one, who had deep faith, says, Lord, when you remember me, when you are in your kingdom, and Jesus tells him, today
you will be with me in paradise.
We believe that these are the words that Jesus is speaking to Albert now. These are the words that Jesus, we hope, we wish that Jesus will speak to Albert. That's why we have come here together to pray that the Lord Jesus will utter the same words to him. And tell him, Albert, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise. May he rest in perfect peace. Amen.
Let us in faith call upon God, your mighty Father, who raised Christ from his Son from the dead, as we pray for the salvation of the living and the dead.
Our response to these intercessory prayers. Lord, hear our prayer.
All together.
Lord. In baptism, Albert Radix received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, Lord, our brother Albert was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Many people die by violence and war and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment and rest and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, the family and friends of Albert seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer. And we are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Albert. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
May the prayer of those who cry to you benefit the souls of your servants, O Lord. Free them, we pray, from all their sins. Make them cherish in your redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Please be seated. Thank you. Cassie, Karen, and Tati, will you stand and go to the main doors of the church, please? Cassie, Karen, and Tati.
Man is lonely, but man is only a pilgrim born. Born to be king, time is but a temporary thing. Only alone while on earth, like the wind on a tree, man has been rather reckless and free. Grown far and wide, he longs to settle down beside the stream flowing through eternity. Like a grass on the lawn, he will pass by the way and
begun, a lesson to learn. We walk but once, there's no return. Time is always moving on.
friends, I have sacrificed the mind. May be acceptable to God, your mighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and the glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His creatures.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Albert, your mercy that he, who did not doubt your son, the loving Savior, to find in him a merciful God. He lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give us thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In the hope of blessed resurrection has gone, that those saddened by the certainty of dying, be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Feed for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. When this heavenly dwelling stands thus, eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. So, with angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, in the name of your glory, as without end, we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Is holy, therefore, these days we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, that they do fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice again. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you for many forgiveness, with this memory of me." the mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, bring us the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, all the clergy. Remember your servant Albert, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with the Son in the death of faith also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers, sisters who have fallen asleep, the hope of the resurrection. All who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, he may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life. We praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Has taught us how to pray. Let us have the courage, therefore, to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and free from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Of the Lord be with you all always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the peace of Christ. Okay.
sins of the world. Lamb of God, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, Lamb of God, have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Jesus Christ. Behold Him. Takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Name the
guardian friend, my prophet, priest, and king. My Lord, my life, my way, my end, accept the praise I bring. When peace like a river attended my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me
let perpetual light shine upon them, your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them, your saints forever, for you are merciful.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Albert may come, eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. Thank you. Godfrey? Thank you, Mr. Godfrey. Renee will deliver our eulogy. I hope I'm saying your name right.
Hello, everybody. We are gathered here today in memory of our brother Albert, but all of you at it, so that we acknowledge and share both our joy and the gift that his life was to us, and the pain that his passing brings. Sharing the joy and the pain together today may lessen the pain and remember more clearly the joy. Albert was 59 years old when he was called home on Friday, July 28th, at Brookdale Hospital. He was born on December 24th, 1963, on the beautiful island of Grenada, to Rosalind Sebastian Thomas and Thelma Thomas. Albert attended St. David's Roman Catholic School and St. David's Secondary School. Upon graduating from secondary school, Albert worked for Grenada's National Commercial Bank, which then garnered him the name Banker. Albert came to America in 1989 and settled in New York. He worked several jobs. His final job was working for the New York Department of Finance. Education was very important to him, which is why he pursued and completed a Bachelor of Science from the University of Bridgeport and a Master of Science from Sacred Heart University. Those were very, very proud days for him. Albert was close to his family and friends. Growing up with Albert as an older brother, well, I'm a cousin, but I stood here 5 years ago and I said, when his mom passed, I said, she was my mom, so he was my brother. Growing up with Albert as an older brother garnered a lot of stories. His two younger sisters, that's Karen and Cassie, could tell you stories of many times he made them reclaim already cleaned areas. He had OCD. As we all know, he was extremely neat, yes he was, and took pride in his appearance. We all know his signature way of wearing his head. Albert's interest was not unlike all of ours. He liked hanging out with friends, listening to music, watching sports, and family get-togethers. Albert also liked the ladies, and the ladies liked him back. There are a few of you sitting in the congregation right now. There are many beautiful aspects to Albert's life and many ways that he touched our lives. He will always be remembered as a wonderful brother, son, father, and friend. In all these ways and more, his presence made our life richer and fuller. Now that he has passed away, of course there is emptiness and pain. But in many ways, the gift of Albert's life is still here with us. He lives in our memories and our stories. So I encourage you to share today, tomorrow, and in the years to come, your memories and stories. And to share the pain of your loss as well. In this way, we will keep the gift of Albert's life alive. Albert is survived by his son, Nyron Randy Sylvester, his brothers, Eddie Raddick, Arnold Raddick, Nicole Hackett, and Justin Thomas. His sisters, Lisa Alexander, Karen Hackett Napier, and Cassandra Thomas. His cousin, me, Renee McMillan, and Paula McMillan Perry. His aunt, Valeria McMillan, Angie Francis, and Annette Francis. Uncles, Tony Francis, Claude Francis. Nieces, Pauline Raddick, Nicole Alexis, Arnell Raddick, Tia Hackett, Riley Napier. Nephews, Terrell Alexander, Keon Napier, Gerard Raddick, and Joshua Raddick. And on behalf of the rest of the family, I would like to thank you all for coming here today. Eddie, can you come for a second? I will not walk away from this altar without saying something directly to you for a minute. You don't have to say anything. What I wanted to say, I didn't think I would get emotional, but what I want to say to all the people who came and supported this guy, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. He is the best. I don't think of him as my cousin. He is the best big brother there ever is. He is the epitome of my brother's keeper. And he will go above and beyond for all of us. Not just family, not just blood, his friends too. He's one of the kindest, sweetest, gentlest, most caring people I know, and I wanted to acknowledge that in front of everybody. You weren't just Albert's big brother. I know it's hard for you today. No matter what was going on with Albert, whether it was the high, the low, the in-between, you were always there. You are always the best big brother, and I wanted to acknowledge that in front of everybody here. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for always staying true to who you are, no matter what's going on. You are who you are, and you've always been
selfless, kind, and I just wanted to say thank you on behalf of all of us. And to the friends who came, they came to his house, they came with a bottle, carrying a bottle under your arm, a bag of something. You were very generous and you showed him the love, and I thank you for that. And I want to say to you that in the week, the months ahead, be there for him, call him up, say, hey guy, how you doing? Send him a text. I think he needs that. He has us for support, but I'd like his friends to support him too. And I just want to say once again, thank you. And thank you.
Everyone, please stand.
I invite you to join me to raise your hands towards the family today. It's a special prayer for the Joseph family. That is son, Aaron. Come here forward. God our Father, we thank you for Aaron, the rest of the family, or brother who praying for. Day, that was strength for them. As that virtues that he possessed to be reborn, son, the rest of the family, that they may keep together strong, be a testimony to the life of God. God, bring them free, Lord, have mercy on them. For us, grant us your mercy and help. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, the love of Christ. Conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Into your hand, we commend our spirit, O Lord. Into your hand we commend our holy Mother, to us held in loving you. Into
your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Albert
the sure, certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him the last day. Give thanks for the blessings which will be bestowed upon Albert in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant. Help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you with our brother forever, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry. All my life you have been faithful.
sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears reduced.